Hi viewer, I welcome you to Edim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Geography Form 3, lesson number 19. The topic it is Action of the River. I'm your tutor, Lucy Muthoni. Welcome. Our lesson goes today, we are going to look at the features resulting from the river deposition. In our previous lesson, we managed to talk about the features that result from the river deposition. We talked about the meandering alluvial fans and the oxbow rick. And today, we want to pick up from there, the braided river channels or the river breaks. This is an extremely wide, shallow channel in which the river divides and subdivides in a series of interconnecting minor channels separated by sandbanks and the islands of alluvium. That is how the river branch looks like. You can be able to see in the river we have the hydrants. There is the deposition that takes place at the middle of the river. The river has been divided. And then finally comes back together. It can also occur like this one, where we have the main load that was being carried by the river deposited in and forming the islands. You can be able to see how now the river is flowing. That is also another example of braided channel. How does the river branch occur? What are the conditions that are necessary for the river branch to occur? One, we have heavily loaded streams flowing between banks of easily eroded material. So now you see it is heavily loaded and there is the reduction of the speed. So deposition takes place. Number two, areas of reduced gradient of the stream. So it must lose that energy of carrying the load. So the next thing, it is deposition. The third one, arid areas where evaporation is high, meaning that the volume of the water will be reduced. Hence, deposition takes place. Fourth, dry season, when the river volume is reduced. Number five, presence of obstacles like rock outcrops, which may cause the river to subdivide. So those are the conditions that are necessary for the river branch to occur. Where are they found? You're going to get them in River Zoia, River Yala, River Sodu, and River Nyando. All these rivers are in Kenya. The fifth one, we have natural ravines. That is the fifth feature. These are raised riverbanks between which a river flows during its old stage. They start forming when the river fronts spilling over its banks and deposition occurs. Coarse materials are deposited first, followed by the finer alluvium that are further carried into the floodplains. This accumulation of coarse materials raise the river banks to the form natural levees. And an example, we have the Wang Hong, this one it is in China, Nyang Kiang, which is also in China, Mississippi, that is found in North America, and Omo, which is found in Ethiopia. You can be able to see how the natural levees are formed. You can see the level of the water. During rainy season, when there is the flooding, you can be able to see where it goes. So, just at the riverbanks, you are going to get the raised levees. That is how the natural levees are formed. We get to the defined tributaries. This is a river that is forced to flow alongside the main river to form for a long distance before being able to join the main river. The tributary then starts flowing parallel to the main river cross the floodplain until it finds a break further downstream where it can join the mainstream. That is the reason why it is referred to the deferred tributaries. Then the seventh one, it is the floodplain. This is a wide floodplain of alluvium on the floor of the river bed, over which the river may spread in times of floods. It is produced through erosion and deposition by a meandering river. As the river meanders, it widens the river valley through rapid erosion, removing the interlocking spurs, reducing them into the low bracts or cliffs. In the process, the meanders migrate downstream, hence widening the river channel. The initial deposition at the end of the strip of slope merge to form continuous alluvium deposit on both sides of the channel. This is the one that we refer to it as the floodplains. During the floods, alluvium is deposited on the entire valley floor, resulting into a floodplain. And they include the effort along the River Zoia, River Yala, River Tana, Nyando, Sabaki. You're going to get those rivers. Activity. Explain the condition necessary for the formation of the river beds. For reference, you can get the KRB 2003 Secondary Geography Student Book 3, that edition. You can also contact us. Either you send an SMS, you can get us from the YouTube, you can also get us from the Facebook, you can also Twitter us. Stay tuned to Elim TV. Thank you.